Hey guys, in this video, we're gonna jump back into the blogger's playbook and we're gonna run down some of our absolute favorite tools that make the blogging and content creation process easier.
Here's an interesting Andrew and Pete fact. We've published our first blog on January the 8th, 2013.
Is that class as interesting?
It was creatively titled the 2013 Business Book Challenge, and it was a horrendously terrible blog post.
We thought people would be interested in the fact that we were going to read lots of business books that year. They weren't.
Fast forward to now, where we're approaching up to 600 pieces of content, including our blogs, vlogs, and our atomic content too. And we've learned a thing or two, or 500 things, about producing content better and quicker.
So today we are going to run through some of our favorite tools that we use for our content and for our blogging. Some are free, some cost a bit of money, but most of them speed up that content creation time. And once implemented, actually using them takes little to no time at all.
And if this is your first time here, please do hit that big red subscribe button. We create videos like this every week to make marketing unboring. That's a word. Let's jump in.
Starting with pre-writing and research tools. For before we even put pen to paper or pixels to screen, we want to make sure what we are actually creating is being searched for. Some businesses have the luxury of this not mattering all that much, but us, we want to be found.
So we use a mix of Google Keywords Planner and AnswerThePublic.com, which are both free tools that will give you keyword ideas for you to write blogs all about. We showed you how to use Answer the Public not so long ago, so click here to go check that out.
We also couple those with a free Google Chrome plugin that we use called Keywords Everywhere, which roughly shows you how many searches that topic is getting per month. Now, do not take this as gospel truth, but do use that as a guide to make sure the keywords that you are finding on the Google Keywords Planner or on Answer the Public actually have some popularity.
Another cool tool we use at this stage is the Braintoss app, which is just a couple of quid on the App Store, but you can also get it on Android as well. What this does is allow us to capture ideas on the go. So if at any moment during the day, if we have an idea, we'll brain toss it.
It basically emails yourself a note that you can action later. You can do written notes, images, and even voice notes, and it integrates with Evernote and Trello too.
The final tool we use at this pre-writing stage is Jotform. We use this for guest blogs. So rather than going back and forth with email a ton of times to get all the information we need, we'll send people to a Jotform link and they can just enter all the information that we require for that guest blog. And we're using the free version of that too.
Next up, we have our actual writing tools. And going back to that horrendous first blog, it was horrendous because it was boring.
Just because it is written word, it doesn't mean it should look boring either. Back in the day, we created this video all about how to make your blogs look sexy. So go check it out.
The first is Google Docs, and all of our ideas start here. Even this video, we freaking love Google Docs. It's basically Microsoft Word, but online, and we can both be editing the same document at the same time and give access to whoever needs access to that document too. It's all stored online, and it's saved as you go, and it's free, and it's ad-free. Google, we love you.
Another cool tool we use is rev.com. Yes, that's the tool that does video subtitles for $1 a minute, but it also allows you to download a transcript of your video. So if you struggle writing or if you have some video content already, you could just speak your blog and get it transcribed via rev.com. It just takes a little titivating and tweaking and you'll have your blog in no time. Easy peasy.
Lemon squeezy. You're squeezing some lemons.
Squeezing some lemons.
You're going to want to be including some images in your blog too. So we could be using Photoshop or Illustrator for this, both of which we have. But 9 times out of 10, we are jumping into Canva and creating something really easily. And if we want to add GIFs into the blog, we are jumping into Giphy.com and we're either searching for a suitable GIF or using Giphy to create our own. And again, we have another video on Giphy over there. Pass Peter.
Watch where you point in that thing. Jesus Christ. Also, if you want to include tweetables in your blog, we love the tool that's free, clicktotweet.com. We'll link to a blog below which shows you exactly how to set that up and how it works, but it's really easy. And in a nutshell, what it allows you to do is pre-populate a tweet, and at the click of a button, people can tweet that pre-populated tweet and share it with all that audience. Nice.
Finally, in this stage, to make sure we have all the SEO boxes ticked, we are using the Yoast plugin with WordPress. This is a really cool tool that tells us what we need to work on from an SEO point of view to make sure the blog is optimized, and has a really nice red, amber, green scoring system that even Pete can follow.
Hey. And in it. After we've pressed the pretty publish button, we've got some tools to use to promote the damn thing.
Starting with ConvertKit for email marketing and ManyChat for Facebook Messenger, send your content to people who have opted in to receive it. This is a really important step, and if you miss this step, then you deserve for your next cup of coffee to be cold.
Yeah, with that mean.
And if you like cold coffee, it's also going to taste of wee.
We're also using social scheduling tools to promote our content going forward. Our favorite tool of the moment is SmarterPulseCal, which is a mashup of SmarterQueue, AgoraPulse, and ContentCal. Our advice to you here is to not do this. We just love them way too much to give any of them up. Just choose one and make sure you use that to promote your content going forward, and promote it more than once.
And a cheeky bonus tool for you as well. We use Disqus, which is a free comments tool that plugs right into WordPress. This allows people to log in to leave a comment, get notifications. It shows some blogs below the comments plugin. This allows people to log in and leave a comment. It also shows some other blogs below the comments plugin. And it does some other fancy stuff too.
So if you've been paying attention, you will now know that our toolbox includes
Google Keywords Planner, Answer the Public, Keywords Everywhere, Braintoss, Jotform, Google Docs, Rev, Canva, Giphy, Click to Tweet, Yoast, ManyChat, ConvertKit, SmarterQueue, AgoraPulse, ContentCal, and Disqus. Didn't edit that together at all. We're going to link to all of those around this video. Somewhere, we're also going to link to some tutorials that we have on some of these tools too, so please do check them out because they all rock.
And if you've loved this video and you want some more marketing unboring, please do subscribe and we'll love you forever and a day.
We always want to add more tools to our toolbox too, so if there's a tool that we haven't mentioned in this video, we want to know your favorite ones that we can check out. So please let us know in the comments.
He's been Andrew.
He's been Pete.
See you next time.